Is artificial intelligence making HD video and image copyright obsolete with this new breakthrough from Sinfusion? As artificial intelligence has advanced, diffusion models like those of OpenAI, Midjourney, and Stable Diffusion have become the leading solution for image and video generation tasks, outperforming generative adversarial networks in various applications. While it's now possible to generate highly realistic images using absurd prompts, this capability comes with a cost. Diffusion models require a large amount of data and are expensive to train, and their high runtime complexity can also be a challenge when using them. It can be convenient to have an AI model that can generate an extensive variety of images or videos in various concepts and settings, but it's likely that we may only want to generate media content for a specific purpose or to explore different scenarios with our favorite images and videos. While it's theoretically possible to achieve this using existing diffusion models, it would be very costly. The process of fine-tuning the diffusion model for a specific input image or video would be time-consuming and require a large amount of data about the desired image or video. The question is, what are the options? Should we avoid using custom diffusion models entirely, or should we expend a lot of resources to come up with a solution? Fortunately, there is a way to take advantage of the generation capabilities of diffusion models for custom inputs without incurring high costs. This solution is called Sinfusion. Sinfusion is a framework designed for training diffusion models on a single input image or video. It leverages the ability of diffusion models to generate high-quality images while implementing various techniques to minimize the cost of fine-tuning. Sinfusion generates new images or videos while preserving the characteristics and concept of the input image or video. Sinfusion excels in generating a diverse range of images from a single image, editing images, creating images from sketches, and creating visual summaries. It also shows strong capabilities in video upsampling, extrapolating videos, both forward and backward in time, and generating new videos from a single video. Sinfusion is based on the denoising diffusion probabilistic model architecture known as DDPM, which is widely used in the deep learning field. To generate images, Sinfusion makes modifications to a DDPM structure. Rather than training on a large dataset of images, it's trained on a large number of random image crops using the input image. The U-net structure at the core of the network is also modified to improve speed. To generate videos, Sinfusion employs a set of modified DDPM modules. One module is used for predicting new frames, another is used to verify the accuracy of the predicted frames, and a third module is used to increase the temporal resolution of the generated videos through interpolation. While Sinfusion and other artificial intelligence video generation models have the potential to revolutionize the way we create and edit video content, they also raise significant concerns about the future of video editing software and copyright law. As AI models become increasingly capable of generating realistic videos from a single input, the need for traditional video editing software may become obsolete. This could have serious consequences for the video editing industry and the professionals who rely on it for their livelihood. In addition, the use of AI-generated videos may also challenge traditional notions of copyright law. Who owns the copyright if AI generates a video that is technically original? This is a question that has yet to be fully answered, and it is an issue that will need to be addressed as AI video generation becomes more prevalent. Overall, while AI video generation has the potential to open up new creative possibilities and streamline the video creation process, it also brings with it significant ethical and legal considerations that must be carefully considered. As this technology continues to evolve, it will be important to consider the implications for both the video editing industry and copyright law. Google's new robotics transformer provides real-world control at scale. Google proposes the Robotics Transformer 1, RT1, a multitask model that tokenizes robot inputs and outputs actions, like camera images, task instructions, and motor commands to enable efficient inference at runtime, which makes real-time control feasible. This model is trained on a large-scale real-world robotics dataset of 130,000 episodes that cover 700-plus tasks, collected using a fleet of 13 robots from everyday robots over 17 months. Google demonstrates that RT1 can exhibit significantly improved zero-shot generalization to new tasks, environments, and objects compared to prior techniques. Moreover, Google carefully evaluates and ablates many of the design choices in the model and training set, analyzing the effects of tokenization, action representation, and dataset composition. Finally, Google is open sourcing the RT1 code and hopes it will provide a valuable resource for future research on scaling up robot learning. To build a system that could generalize to new tasks and exhibit robustness to different distractors and backgrounds, Google collected a large, diverse dataset of robot trajectories. Google used 13 EDR robot manipulators, each with a 7-degree of freedom arm, a 2-fingered gripper, and a mobile base, to do these 700 tasks, including picking and placing items, opening and closing drawers, getting items in and out drawers, placing elongated items upright, knocking objects over, pulling napkins, and opening jars. The results of the Google researchers indicate that RT1 is able to acquire new skills by observing the experiences of other robots. In particular, the 22% accuracy seen when training with EDR data increases by almost 2 times to 39% when RT1 is trained on both bin-picking data from KUKA and existing EDR data from robot classrooms. Mixing data from both robots allows RT1 to infer the actions of the EDR robot when faced with the states observed by KUKA, without explicit demonstrations of bin picking on the EDR robot, and by taking advantage of experiences collected by KUKA. This presents an opportunity for future work to combine more multi-robot datasets to enhance robot capabilities. New robotics that walk on walls. Scientists at the Korea Advanced Institute of Science and Technology and the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign have developed a quadruped robot with magnetized feet that enables it to climb metal structures. The robot is capable of moving on walls and ceilings in metal buildings and structures. The researchers published a paper in Science Robotics in which they detail their robot and its performance during real-world testing. The aim of this project was to create a robot that could assist with maintenance tasks on large metal structures, such as bridges, oil tanks, and some buildings. As technology has advanced, engineers have discovered new ways to utilize robots. The researchers developed a 4-legged robot that can walk on flat surfaces, climb walls like a spider, and even traverse ceilings when necessary. This robot is designed to carry out maintenance work on large metal structures. The robot's feet are equipped with both magnetic elastomers and electromagnets, which allow them to magnetize and demagnetize on demand. This enables the robot to cling to vertical surfaces using a single foot while the other feet remain attached, and to release one foot at a time to take steps. The robot is able to carry out these actions by turning the magnetism on and off. The researchers had to program the robot to initiate a climb by simulating how a cat tests a surface before moving forward, taking small steps with its front paws before adding the movement of its back paws. Lab testing revealed that the robot was able to climb metal walls and walk across ceilings. Additional testing demonstrated that the robot was able to climb an old outdoor storage tank with rust-covered walls and navigate over non-metal surfaces or around obstacles. It was also able to carry a weight of up to 3 kilograms with a maximum speed of 0.7 meters per second.